Hello ladies and gentlemen, welcome to a new Photoshop tutorial with PSEbox. I hope you had a nice Valentine's Day. It's time to go back to Photoshop, and today I'm going to show you how to create a very simple but abstract, let's call it manipulation in Photoshop. I'm going to show you how to make this sort of 3D reflection. It's really easy. I'm going to use Photoshop CC 2018, but you can use any Photoshop version that has a 3D features. If you use Photoshop CS, I think you need the CS extended, but in any case, I'm gonna include this shape and some others so you can download it on the website. You can find the links on the video description if you're watching this from YouTube, and you can go to my website and download these shapes and do this on your own. So I hope you will enjoy it, and let's get started. You can use any photograph to create this. I use this one, I think it has a more impact. So I'm gonna go to edit, copy, I use the same one, and I'm gonna create a new document. And I'm gonna paste it here. So the first thing you wanna do is create a new layer. If you're using the 3D feature, you need to create a new layer. If you just download the shapes that I'm gonna create, simply paste that shape on this new layer. I'm going to show you how I made it. I went to 3D with the new layer selected, went to new mesh from layer, mesh preset, and I used a pyramid. You can use the cube if you want, but I'm going to use the pyramid because I like it better. And yes, I want to go to the 3D workspace. And I'm not an expert in 3D in Photoshop. And if you're not an expert either, don't worry, it's really easy what we're going to do. Just select the 3D tab here, select the pyramid, and here on the bottom left, you can see we have these controls. This will help us rotate our object. And you will notice that it also, it has this shadow here, which is automatically created, but we're gonna deal with that a bit later. Just rotate your pyramid like this, and I don't wanna have it just front facing like this, but if this is one what you want to create, you can do it. I'm gonna just move it slightly like that to have it a bit sideways, like so. And you don't want to have something like this, just make it look like it's standing. And with this other control, with the dolly, the 3D camera, just move it a bit forward so you can see it on the screen. And probably I'm gonna leave it there. If you want to deactivate the shadow, just select the infinite light. And here on the top, if you have this screen, just click here on the properties and deactivate shadow, and that's it. Do not deactivate the light because we need it. So I'm gonna put it right there, like that. And probably rotate this a little more, like so. And now we have to change the color of this faces here because we need to have them on separate layers, and if we have solid color, it's gonna be easier. So I'm gonna scroll through the faces here. I think this one, the front material, is one of them, and just give them a solid color, and then locate another one. I think this is the left material. Yep, I'm gonna use a stronger color, a red tone for this, and click OK. Now, what you will be able to download from my website is a shape like this. I'm gonna include several angles, so you can use on different artworks if you want, on different angles. And now I'm gonna go to layers again. You can see this 3D layer here. I'm gonna right click on it and choose Rasterize 3D. If you wanna include the original shadow created by the light, you have to right click and choose Render 3D instead, but it's gonna take a while, so I'm not gonna do it here. And what we're gonna do now is select the magic one. I'm gonna switch back to my workspace. Select the magic wand, I have the tolerance 35 point sample and contiguous on. Select this layer and click on one of the colors on one of the faces and right click and choose layer via cut. And you can see now I split this into individual layers. Now, I'm gonna name this face one and the other one face two. And in order to create that reflection is really easy. We just have to duplicate the background layer and drag it on top of one of the faces and alt click to create it as a clipping mask, and then create another copy and drag it up and clip it to the other face. So basically you have this layout here on the layers palette. Then with the move tool, with the V key you select it, just click and move this a little, and you have it. And that's how I created this, really easy, as I said. I'm gonna shift it just a little, it's gonna look weird, and I'm gonna put this one right over there, I guess. Or, well, I wanna see some of those cars there, and probably I'm gonna leave it there. And next, in order to see the ground there, we have to create the shadow. Oops, this one has to be a bit more towards the left. In order to create the shadow, I'm gonna create a new layer on above the background and under this shape. And I'm gonna name it shadow. And I'm gonna get the polygonal lasso tool. If you don't see the faces here, just deactivate these two layers for a second so you can see the edges, and leave some space between the edge and your selection. And I'm gonna start from here. Parallel to that edge, I'm gonna create a point there and another one there, and then an imaginary line there, and double click. So now I'm gonna fill this with black. Make sure you have the foreground color set to black and that you're on the shadow layer, and press Alt or Option Backspace. This will fill this with black, as you can see. Move it down a little bit, like so, and soften it using the Gaussian filter. So go to Filter, Blur, and choose Gaussian Blur. And increase the radius. For this canvas size, 45 or 50 pixels, it's okay, and you can see how it looks like. And I'm gonna reactivate these two layers, and it looks like now this pyramid is setting, sitting on the ground there. Now I have to add some layer styles to the faces because I want to be able to tell the difference between these two, between the two faces. You have several options here. For example, if I select face one, which is this one, I can add, for example, a gradient overlay and try to make it perpendicular to the shape there and just darken this a bit. And I'm gonna set it on maybe overlay, and I'm gonna do the same to face two, gradient overlay, but this time I'm gonna change the angle like that and the scale a little smaller like that. Or you can use inner shadow if you want to add the shadow on all sides. Let's do activate it here as well with a really low opacity set to overlay like that. You can see here on the top, on the tip, you can now tell the difference without the layer styles and with the layer styles. My hard drive is really slow. Okay, so we're pretty much done. On the original, I made more adjustments here. You can see I made more adjustments here. You can download the PSD file for free on resources.psdbox.com and investigate how I made this. But this is the basic technique that I used. Now let's make some final adjustments. I'm gonna add maybe, I don't know, a color lookup, and I'm gonna use the make sure you change to Essentials or your own workspace, otherwise you will not be able to open this. And I'm gonna use maybe the DK79. I'm gonna include this DK79 preset on the download. I'm gonna unclip it. Make sure you put it on top of everything. If you wanna load it, simply just click here, load 3D LUT, and locate this DK79.rec70932 cube, and that's it. I'm gonna drop the opacity to about maybe 30% or something like that, and then add another one. And I'm gonna use Cobalt Carmine. If you're using an older version of Photoshop and you don't have the color lookup, it doesn't matter. Now I'm gonna merge everything onto a new layer. I'm gonna press Shift Alt Command E or Shift Option Command E on a Mac, or Control instead of Command. And now I'm gonna go to Filter and choose Camera Raw Filter. And if you don't have the Camera Raw filter there, you save it as a TIFF file. Save this document as a TIFF file and then open it back in Photoshop, and you should enter the Camera Raw mode. And I'm gonna increase the clarity here and the vibrance and a bit the saturation. Here you can tweak this however you like. Maybe a color tone will look nice. Like that. And maybe some split toning. I don't like the blue tone there. And maybe something like that, and some post-crop vignetting, and really soft, so I'm gonna increase the feather. And this tone, I don't really like it, so with the camera calibration, you can change the tones here to whatever you want. Maybe desaturate those reds, and add more of that here. I don't know, maybe I'm gonna leave it like that and click OK. And I'm gonna show the before and after. Before camera raw and after. Here the sides are not really well defined. Here I have an overlay layer, which has some shadow on it, and that's why you can see. Let me uncheck this so you can see. See that I have a shadow on that side there and here as well. But anyways, that's how I created. You can see the before and after here as well. That's how I created this. It's really easy, as you can see. I hope you enjoyed it, and if you have any comments or any suggestions for new tutorials, just post a comment on the video or on my website, and I'll try to make them. Also, make sure you subscribe. I'm going to publish new videos each week, and I hope you will like them all. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.